Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing very well. Okay, and always you should doing very well. Okay, my wish is that only. So just trying to add a small thing in that goodness, because always we know knowledge, definitely nothing is too good than good knowledge. And definitely when we are bound to study, that means we have to study. No other options. So today we'll start a new unit under the management accounting subject. Okay, fund flow statement, I hope you have understood and you can do it. Still you will have any doubt, then you can ask me on the WhatsApp, no issues at all. Okay, so today we'll start the new topic, new unit, that is cash flow statement. Okay, so very first we'll check out what is the meaning of cash flow statement. Okay, so it is a financial statement which summarizes the amount of cash and cash equivalents, okay, entering and leaving a company. Okay, so what the cash and cash equivalent entering into the company, what the cash and cash equivalent leaving the company, okay, this particular cash flow statement, financial statement, is going to summarize those amount. Okay, and it used to measure how well a company manages its cash position. Okay, meaning how well the company generates cash to pay its debt obligations and fund its operating expenses. And this we are going to for a particular specific period, we are able to find out how much cash we have on hand. Okay, so why we need the cash flow statement, or you can say the what is the advantages, okay, for preparing the cash flow statement. So very first is the cash flow statement show the liquidity of the company. Okay, that whenever we are going to prepare the cash flow statement, definitely we will come to know exactly how much operating cash flows, okay, and then how much you have used it. Fine, so what can, like, and then you will able to know that what next you can afford or what you can't afford it. Okay, so it will show your liquidity position. Then another thing is it shows the changes in assets, liabilities and equity in the form of cash outflows and cash inflows and cash being held. Okay, so your assets, liabilities, equities, okay, whatever is changing in the form of cash outflow, or it can be in the cash inflow, or it can be like cash somewhere held. Okay, you haven't received it or you haven't paid it, but it's supposed to received or what you are supposed to pay, so it is holding. Okay, so this is like core of our each and any business accounting. Fine, so it will help you to measure the company performance. Okay, and then definitely when you know very well, fine, what is your liquidity position, then you can plan very well, okay, what your business will have in the future. Okay, and definitely it is like important for making long term business plans. Okay, and even if company is planning to go for securing a loan or line of credit, then also company has to they have to submit, okay, they required up to date cash flow statement. Clear? So these are the reasons why any company need cash flow statement. Now for us like a student, okay, to prepare the cash flow statement, we have two methods, just like your fund flow statement, direct method and indirect method. So under the direct method, okay, the major heads of cash inflows and outflows, that is your cash received from the trade receivables, employees, benefits, expenses, etc., we have to consider. Okay, we will have the items cash receipts from the customers, okay, which generally include your revenue from the operations, trade receivables in the beginning, and then minus your trade receivables in the end. Okay, cash payments to the suppliers, okay, purchase, so are your cash expenses, like expenses on accrual basis. Fine. So these all we used to consider under the direct method. And only the thing is, what change? Cash received from operating revenues to change. Fine. And definitely, as I have mentioned for you here also, okay, cash received from the operating revenue and cash payment for operating expenses are calculated and shown in the cash flow statement. Okay, items like, as I told just now, cash sales of goods and services, cash received from the debtors, cash payment to the creditors. So those things when we go for the direct method. Okay, further definitely we will solve the problems also in the next classes. And then we have the another method, that is indirect method. Okay, see, direct and indirect, both method is available even in your under fund flow statement and even in your cash flow statement to calculate the, in case of fund from operation, to calculate fund from operation, in case of cash flow statement, to calculate cash flow from operating activities. Okay, and here also, that is in your cash flow statement also, fine, this calculation under indirect method begins with the amount of net profit or loss. Reason, similar to your fund flow statement. Okay, because statement of profit and loss, okay, incorporates the effects of all operating activities of an enterprise. Fine. And actually your profit and loss is prepared on accrual basis and not on cash basis. So it includes your non-cash item, non-operating items also. Fine. So definitely it is necessary to adjust those amounts with your net profit or loss, and then we used to able to arrive at cash flow from operating activities. So these are your two methods which we can use in your cash flow statement also. Okay, now the three things we have, most important little bit changes, okay, from your fund flow statement solving pattern. So okay, if I want to compare, now in your fund flow statement we used to first go for the statement changes in working capital, where we used to take all the current assets and current liabilities, and then we used to calculate the fund from operation, and then we used to prepare the fund flow statement. In cash flow statement, main focus towards your cash. Okay, and here we have to divide the statement of cash flow under three activities. Okay, or we can say that it are like components of cash flow statement. One is your operating activities, that is cash from operating activities. Another is cash from investing activities. And then another is the last one, cash from financing activities. Okay, statement of cash flow will definitely have these three subheadings. Okay. And how we used to calculate under your or to find out, like under your fund flow statement, that where fund is coming inside, which are the sources, which are the applications, same here also we have to do. Here also we have to find out which are the sources, which are the applications, which are the non-cash, which are the non-operating, which are the current asset, which are the current liability. Same things here also we have to identify. Only the posting method will get changed. Okay, so let's check out one by one the three sections of your cash flow statement. So very first we have a cash flow from operating activities, that is cash earned or spent in the course of regular business activities. Okay, that is your main way of making money by selling products or services. Fine. So here it include any source or uses of cash from business activities, that is how much cash is generated from a company's product or services. This is first heading, and here only we apply either the direct method or either the indirect method, but maximum we use the indirect method only. Fine. Now the next component is your cash flow from investing activities, that is cash earned or spent from investments your company makes, such as purchasing equipment or investing in other companies. So here we mainly focus, okay, changes in the balance of long term and fixed assets. Okay, so how much we are purchasing the fixed assets, how much we are selling the fixed assets, what's happening with the our fixed assets, how much we have invested in the another company, how much we have lost in that, or how much we had the gain. So those things actually relate here. Okay, in simple terms, if I have to say, then it relates to the purchase and sale of long-term assets or fixed assets, like your machinery, furniture, land and building. Okay, like if I have to say that what are the cash outflow from investing activity, then I can say as the example, like cash payment to acquire a fixed asset, okay, or cash advances and loans made to the third party, fine, or cash payment to acquire shares. So those things actually comes here, but what we have to say, just for you people, you have to keep remember that purchase and sale of long-term assets or fixed assets, that is most important, okay, under your cash flow from investing activities, okay, or if you are investing in some other companies, some different types of instruments like shares, debts, warrants, whatever, fine. Next we have the third component is cash, okay, flow from financing activities. Okay, so financing activities, that results in changes in the size and composition of owner's capital and borrowings of the enterprise. So for example, you have to keep remember, like cash proceeds from issue of equity shares, debentures, raising long-term loans, repayment of bank loans, those all things comes here. Okay, so if anything is related to the changes in balance of long-term liabilities or capital structure or dividend policy or debt financing, those all comes under the heading of financing activities. I'm repeating one more time all the three for you. Operating activities, what you are getting or spending, that is cash inflow or cash outflow because of your regular business activities, okay, that is products and services, regular activities, companies, products and services, okay. And investing, that is whatever the related to the changes of fixed assets and long terms assets or investments in the another companies, what, how much cash came inside or how much cash gone outside. And then the last is financing activities related to the company's capital structure, dividend policy, long term liabilities. Okay, so because of that, how much extra you have issued the shares, or how much extra you have issued the debentures, okay, or how much you have repayment of amounts borrowed, or how much interest you have paid on debentures, okay, or long term loans or advances, how much interest you have paid for those things, or how much dividend you have paid on equity or preference capital, whatever. So those all things will comes under your cash flow from financing activities. So all the three headings you have to keep remember, and same time you have to keep remember what comes under those three headings. Okay, again and again I am saying, business activities heading is your operating activities, then your fixed assets, long term assets or investment in another company related, then the heading will be investing activities, and whatever is related to your issuance of shares, debentures, that is your capital structure or dividend policies or your finances, those all will come under the financing activities. Clear? Yes or no? See, one small thing, just I'll give you the example. If just suppose in the question, dividend paid, you pay the dividend, you paid the dividend, sorry, dividend paid. So that is your part of financing activities, because you are paying the dividend because you had in your capital structure, or you had the debt financing. So that's why you're paying the dividend. Okay, so that is financing activity. But if it is given in the question, dividend received, that means you have invested in some other company and on that now you are receiving the invest dividend, so that will go with as your investing activities. So small small things you have to keep remember. Okay, and here just try to go for this. Okay, I have given the format. This is the direct method format for calculating your cash from operating activities. And similar to this, see, again I am saying, last time also I have told that direct method or indirect method only change the first point, that is cash from operating activities. Remaining your cash flow from investing activity and cash flow from financing activities are going to be the same. Okay, so this is your this is your direct method and this is your indirect method. So indirect method, how we used to go for that fund from operation, okay, taking the closing balance of profit and in that adding all the non-cash and non-operating or non-fund expenses or losses and deducting from that all non-cash, non-operating, non-fund your income or gains, till that it will be same, but only small new thing what added in your cash flow statement. In cash flow statement, if you can focus here, okay, we have to go for some adjustments for the changes in current assets and liabilities. So again here we have the four rules. Okay, decrease in current asset, increase in current liability, we need to add. Okay, decrease in current asset, increase in current liability, we need to add. And then decrease in current liability and increase in, okay, sorry, they have given here this is printing mistake, just correct it. Okay, it is going to be the increase in current increase in current assets. Okay, you have to deduct. And then finally we have to deduct, if we have in the question, that income tax paid, so that item will come here. And then we will arise to the net cash flow from operating activities. Okay, and yes, then the last I have given you what we are going to follow, the format of cash flow statement, very simple. First heading, cash flow from operating activity. Second heading, cash flow from investing activity. And then cash flow from financing activity. And then we need to calculate how much net increase or decrease in the cash balance. Okay, in that we need to add the cash balance, that is opening balance of cash, which is will be given in your balance sheet in the question, and making sure that we are going to receive the closing balance of cash as the final answer. Okay, so just go for this. Kindly copy your all the format also in your notebook. Okay, and just for your reference, as I'm really sorry, I saw now this mistake, so I just want to correct it again. Fine, increase in current liability and decrease in current asset, we need to add. So that means the first portion, that first two rule is correct. We have to add these two. Okay, decrease in current asset and increase in current liability. This is no problem at all, there is no mistake. But only what we need to deduct, in case of deduction, decrease in current liability. Okay, decrease in current liability and increase in current asset. Increase in current asset only in here, the fourth rule. Okay, four rule what? First rule is decrease in current asset, second rule is increase in current liability, we need to add. Next rule is what? Decrease in current liability, third rule that is, and then increase in current asset. Okay, increase in current asset, we need to deduct. Clear? I hope it is clear now. Okay, so just go for the classes, try to copy your all the formats, and I hope you can make it. So thank you, have a nice day, enjoy your day.